No, I don't see him. Yeah, Bharat, are you there? Okay, Amitava Mukherjee.
Hello. Hi. Yes, I want to ask regarding the pitch. How is the pitch behaving, and can India be able to save? Will India be able to save the match tomorrow? Can bat the whole day?
The pitch has been quite slow, and it's been good to bat. The balls that we saw misbehave yesterday, going up and down, has also kind of come down because of the slow nature of the pitch. And I also think roller is playing a role because the game started off with the pitch not seeing a lot of sun. I think as the sun is building down, the wicket is actually getting better to bat. As a team behind in, that we are behind in the game, we are very hopeful that we can put together a good performance in the first session tomorrow.
Kushan Sarkar followed by Vishesh Roy and Swarup.
Ashwin, just wanted to ask you, is this the first time that we have seen such racial abuse being hurled at Indian cricketers, and how difficult it is mentally for a debutant who is being vilified like that? Like, how did the team react, and how was the mental space after these incidents happened for the 2 days?
Look, I'd like to point out something. This is my fourth tour to Australia, and Sydney, especially here, we've had a few experiences even in the past. And I think one or two times even the players have reacted and have got into trouble in the past. And that's not because of the player. It is actually because of the way the crowd has been speaking, especially the people on the lower tier of the stands. They have been quite nasty. They have been hurling abuses as well. But this is a time where they've actually gone one step higher and used racial abuses. And like we already mentioned, there was an official complaint that we lodged yesterday. And the umpires also mentioned that we must bring it to their notice as it happens on the field. And then they'll be able to take action. And it is definitely not acceptable in this day and age where we've come through. We've seen a lot, right? We evolved as a society. And sometimes I think this roots back to the upbringing and the way one sees. So this must be definitely dealt with iron fists, and we must make sure that it doesn't happen again.
Yes, Swarup.
Hi, Ashwin.
Just a clarification. When I said iron fist, it is not a physical thing. It's the way we deal with it.
Hi, Ashwin. Just an elaboration on that question. You know, apart from the racial abuse, the team has suffered some injuries. Kohli has gone back. We don't yet know if Pant Jadeja will bat in the last innings. So how exactly is the mental space of the team? What exactly are you guys telling each other in the team meetings?
Look, I think just for clarification, it's already been made that Pant will bat, right? I think the broadcasters are also made sure that it was announced. I think he will bat. Definitely the bruise was quite severe, and it was quite painful. The elbow can be a very tricky place to deal with. As a cricket team, we've not really, as a team inside the dressing room, we haven't really spoken about how things are not going our way. Sometimes when they don't go your way, they don't. And that's how the sport is. But we refrain from talking about things that are not in our control. We can only do what we can do, and we can control what we can. And I personally feel with whatever has been thrown at us, we have responded in a very warrior-like fashion, and we'd like to continue and take the fight even tomorrow. So, if we can control what we can control, that's all we can ask from everyone.
Yes, Vishesh Roy.
Hi, Ash. I just wanted to elaborate on the racial slurs point only. Team India lodged an official complaint yesterday, so was it disappointing to see the crowd continuing today as well? And have you noticed these incidents happening in the other two venues in Adelaide and Melbourne, or Sydney is the first time you're experiencing it?
Personally, I think Adelaide and Melbourne wasn't as bad. But like I said, this has been a continual thing at Sydney. I've personally experienced it as well. They do tend to get nasty. I don't know why or what, for what reason. Or they don't, you know, unless and until it is dealt with, people don't really find the necessity to, you know, look at it in a different way. In fact, I was quite surprised that some sections of the crowd continuously did it, and there were not mates around them to pull them up for it. That was quite surprising as well. So, it definitely had to be dealt with. And disappointing is actually a very, very mild word, I must say.
Surinan, sir?
अश्विन, जब ऐसा मौका आता है कि डिफिकल्ट टाइम्स बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ जाते हैं तो कई बार ऐसे होता है कि टीम ज्यादा नजदीक आती है, दे कम टुगेदर मोर।
एब्सोल्युटली सर, मुझे तो ऐसा लगता है कि तब एडवर्सिटी ज्यादा होते जाता है, टीम एक साथ आता है। वो एक मौका था कि तब इवन आफ्टर द एडिलेड टेस्ट हम लोग एक साथ मिलकर बातचीत किया, एक टीम इवेंट भी हुआ। And I thought we got together pretty tight after that game, and that was a result we saw in that MCG win also. And it was, we were looking really, really positive coming into the game, into this game as well. But you know, such innocuous things, Jadeja's ball just from a back of link ball just raced and hit him, and he got injured going into the second innings. You know, sometimes these things happen and it does set you back. I won't say that it is not a setback, but it is what it is. Even recently in the game against South Africa and Sri Lanka, I think Sri Lanka lost about 4 or 5 people in the first test during the game. I think we haven't seen lockdowns. We haven't, you know, put this body to so much of rest in the last 8 months. And sometimes when they say when it pours, when it rains, it does pour. So this is one of those times. But like I said, it's an opportunity to show what sort of metal we are all made of. And everybody is putting a good fight.
It's Amol Karadkar and Vivek Krishnan.
Ashwin, coming back to the racial slur point, as in, you spoke about this being having happened to an extent earlier as well. So at what point does you as a squad eventually end up saying enough is enough, now we can't take it any longer? And how much has it been a distraction to the bunch when it comes to sticking, as in focusing on cricket as such?
Look, if I take back my first tour, take myself back to the first tour that I came here in 2011 and 12, I had no clue about what racial abuse is, or how you can be made to feel small in front of so many people, and the people actually laugh at you when you get abused. There are like another set of people who laugh along with these things happening. I had no idea what this was at all. So it was quite a bit of, you know, whenever you stood at the boundary line, you wanted to just run in another 10 yards to evade yourself from all these things. But as things have strode on and we've learned more and more on tours, this is definitely not acceptable. And even yesterday when Siraj brought it up, Ajinkya, Rohit and myself, we all got together and we went to the umpire and did report it. Nowadays, the boys are much better equipped. Even like someone like Siraj, who's come in new, he does know that this is a line that someone cannot overstep. And even if it is from the boundary line, it's a wonderful thing. And it must be met the way it was met. And we must say that we were all quite happy that those people were evicted.
Okay, Vivek Krishnan.
Hello, Ashwin. Ashwin, in the past, the current Indian team has always said that the intent will be to go for a win and not really a draw, especially in Adelaide 2014. With the game situation right now, what will be the approach of the team tomorrow? Do you think 395 overs is out of reach, or what will be the approach? Will it be to still go for the victory? And also, how much of a role do you see Lion playing tomorrow? Do you think the wicket is taking spin?
Both these questions I need to be answering very carefully. See, I think firstly, in a test match, you don't look at the overall score and say going into a final day that we must go for a win. It doesn't happen quite so much like it happens in white ball cricket. There are passages of play, and the red ball game is much more different, and you're playing on a day 5 pitch. So sometimes when you play to the merit of the ball and just, you know, have the hunger and just crave in, you put yourself in a situation at the last session where you can take a dish at it. But you don't go into the morning saying, chalo hum 300 bana denge. That's not how you play the game. And last time when we spoke about it at Adelaide, it was, you know, everybody got off to a good start and the game paced itself that way. And we did believe that we can get it because the score was in our range. And tomorrow as well, a batsman walking in will believe that they can do it. That belief is very important when you step onto the park tomorrow morning. With respect to what will happen with what Nathan Lyon is doing is his job. And I cannot necessarily say that he will come into play or he won't come into play. We will put ourselves in the best possible situation to play every bowlers of theirs with on merit of that particular ball and not really think too much about a particular individual. And with respect to what the wicket is doing, you're all seeing it. And the wicket is slow and it will be that way. I don't see very many demons in it.
We've received one question on chat. It's from Prajakta, who says, can we say that the foundation has been laid by Rohit and Shubman, and how crucial will the forthcoming partnerships be?
Look, obviously, it's very, very important that we play a good first session out tomorrow. A very, very ideal and a good first session for us will be not losing a wicket. And these two gentlemen out there have proven all through their career about how good they are playing this format of the game and playing many good knocks for us. And Ajinkya has got 100 in the MCG. Pujji made a 50 in the first inning. So we are all very hopeful that they will put a good performance.
We'll take last one or two questions. Any raised hands? I don't see any more raised hands. Yeah, Shriram Veera.
Hi, Ashwin. This is just about the running between the wickets. Do you tell any of your colleagues or whatever, is there any discussion that this slightly close single is best to avoid? Or, this cannot be planned. But is there any such talk or would you like to, let them know, basically.
Look, I don't think you can... Sometimes it is just a backlog of what's happened. It can have an impact on people walking into bat in the next innings. It's not happened at all for the last 100 years. I've been told by someone that it's not happened in the last 110 years or whatever it is, that three runouts have happened in a game. And
No, I meant you were running between the wickets. Yeah.
Sorry?
I meant... let me rephrase. I meant you were running between the wickets. Especially when you're paired with a guy like Jadeja who's very quick, is there a chat that thoda sambhal konjam path se be careful type, is there anything like that happens? Or
look, if it is in all honesty, I might not be the quickest of runners, but I actually judge a run pretty well. It's not like I've been run out very often in the test format, and the communication between me and Jaddu yesterday was very clear on the calling. Yesterday I heard his call very, very late, and he was almost halfway through the pace when he actually said Ash Bagja ek run. So it can happen. Maybe he could have called a little earlier and I didn't hear it in the heat of the in all the noise or whatever it is. So for me, okay, that's one of the reasons why I was looking at where the ball was going. If you've not received a call, you're looking for help through where the ball's gone. So for me, that was that. Because I played cricket with proper basics for the years to understand that front of the wicket is a striker's call. So for me, there was no reason to be looking behind if I'd got a call.
Yeah, cool. The final two now. Bharat Sundaresan and Rob Forsyth.
Hey Ashwin, I'm sorry. I think I joined the call a little late. Have you spoken about the Siraj incident at all? I'm sorry.
Yes.
It's been
time. perfect. I expected that. No, Ashwin, just like you and Steve Smith, like, if you can just the match scenario out. He's approached you very differently in this... in this game, both innings. So just about that battle and him seems to have, he said like you dictated the terms in the first two tests and it seems like he's doing the same. So you can just talk about that battle.
We expect quality players to come out with different plans. For starters, I'd like to say that the wicket has had much lesser bounce and much lesser pace than MCG and Adelaide. And Sydney has tended to be that way over the years. So this was actually slower than a regular Sydney pitch, maybe because of the amount of sun it received before getting into the game. And there was a clear strategy from Smith and Marnus to, not defend much and push at balls. And a combination of the pitch and their strategy to push at balls that they haven't really covered also really worked for them. But I definitely thought in the second innings, I put them through much more, pressure than what it was in the first innings, because the wicket was also a touch better than what it was on the first day. It is a duel that I'm completely enjoying. It is a wonderful battle. Stephen Smith and Marnus, both of them are quality batsmen. And I'm happy that I got them out again in this innings.
Yeah, final one now, Rob Forsyth.
Hi, sorry, sending some audio issues. There's a report out of the Times of India that the BCCI is committed to playing the fourth test at the Gabba. Firstly, do you know if that's the case? And secondly, has that sort of speculation and just the discussions between the boards about sort of biosecurity rules and whatnot been a distraction at all?
Look, first thing first, the Indian cricket team is a team that's definitely not looked into all these things at all. The board decides what we do and like contracted, players of the board, we just follow what the board says. And I'm sure they will definitely work things out in the best interest of their cricket team and the situation that's existent. So we believe and trust in what the decision that they will make. And they've always made best decisions in our interest.
Thank you, everyone.